a more common recent trend when you're discounting to get a net present value of a cash flow is instead of using a constant discount rate, so for example, for these cash flows, perhaps we use 25% the whole time, what we do is we use multiple discount rates, the logic being that certain years are more risky than others. So for example, this is a construction project, and the first 2 years are 25%, that's what we need. And then once it's constructed, it should be a little bit less risky, so you'll see it goes to 15 and then 12.5% once it's in steady state. The mistake we often see is people make use of these multiple discount rates, but the way they do it is they work out a discount factor, but what they're doing is they're treating it the traditional way. And you'll see the problem comes over here. So in terms of this formula, what it's saying is tell me what 1 3 years time is worth at 15%. The problem is that's not the correct calculation, because this 15% was preceded by 2 25%. What this is effectively assuming is that was actually 25 and 25. And you can see it's a problem, because look at what this is saying. An amount of 1 in 2 years time is worth 64 cents, but in 3 years time it's actually worth 66 cents, so it's actually improved with time, and that doesn't make sense. What this would mean is you'd rather have people give you money a year later to get the higher amount. The problem with this is that when you look and you use the PV factor to PV calculation to do the PV to do the factor, this 15% is assumed to be in all of those. So the correct way to do it is you have to modify the discount factor a bit. So we'll just go to this one here, and you'll notice that in this calculation, what we're doing is we're taking the previous year's amount and we're using only the 1 year factor. So here we've got a 1, there what we're saying is Excel, tell me in only 1 year's time, what is 1 worth in a year's time? The next one then, instead of looking at the 1, it now says the future value is not a 1, but it's the 80 cents we calculated previously. The result of that is that this makes a lot more sense. Money initially is worth 1, then a factor of 0.8, 0.64, 0.56, etc. And you can see the difference in total is significant. If we do this, all our cash inflows are coming in at a discount rate of 15% and lower. So it looks like this is a great project. But we haven't taken into account that we have to first go through 2 years of significant risk, 25% risk. And so the actual correct NPV is this 932, which is sort of 2/3 of the initial value.